Good morning, BHS! I'm your host, Kyle.
And I'm Zach.
Today is September 27th, and it's a day 5. Now let's hop in the news.
Now for some important information.
Now that the members of the BHS crescendo have been selected, the rehearsals will be held every Tuesday starting September 28th.
And probably starting up on September 29th. It will take place every Wednesday.
Attention BHS grads of 2022, the grad semi-formal will be taking place October 14th. Everyone in attendance must be double vaccinated. The tickets will cost $60 and can be purchased with cash or check made out to Beaconsfield High School from October 4th to the 6th in B307 during lunch. Check your emails for more information.
Here's sports news with Mika.
Thank you, Zach. Want to keep your gym mark up? The Athletics clothing sale is ongoing. Until October 3rd, check out the link on the BHS Instagram or the Athletics website to take advantage. Congrats on the top three runners from the Terry Fox Run. Top three Cycle 1 students were Emil Bernstein, Noah Lagunalit, and Emily Phillip. Top three from Cycle 2 were Alan Kearney, Jacob Silverman, and Jaden Hamm. The top three teachers were Mr. Ali, Mr. Nardoza, and Ms. Crutchfield. Back to you, Kyle.
Thank you, Mika. Here is a segment for the Orange Shirt Day.
At Beaconsfield High School, we have a Truth and Reconciliation Committee.
On September 30th, we invite all staff and students to recognize the truth about Indian residential schools in Canada and support the reconciliation. We ask you to wear an orange shirt. Here is a video explaining the meaning and significance of wearing an orange shirt on September 30th.
Hello everyone, my name is Phyllis Webstad. I am Shawetmuk from the Strachamuk, Kennel Creek, Khatstam, Dog Creek First Nation, which is about 1.5 hours southwest from Williams Lake, BC. I grew up with my granny on the Dog Creek Reserve until I was 10, then moved with my auntie after she finished university. When I had just turned 6, I was sent to the St. Joseph Indian Residential School near Williams Lake, a place we called the Mission. My granny bought me a shiny new orange shirt to go to school in. When I got there, I was stripped, my clothing taken away, including my new orange shirt, and I never saw it again. I was no longer excited to be going to school. I wanted to go home to Granny. I had to stay there for 300 sleeps. No matter how much all of us little kids cried, it didn't matter. No one listened to us. Our feelings didn't matter. We didn't matter. I am the third generation that attended residential school. Both my grandmother and mother attended the Mission for 10 years each. Today is a day to honor and remember residential school survivors and their families. Every child matters, even if you're an adult. We must also remember those children that never made it and are no longer with us. Today is a day for survivors to tell their stories and for us to listen with open hearts. I am humbled and honored that you are all taking part in Orange Shirt Day. When I was in school, I didn't know my own history, so I am overjoyed that you are taking part and learning the true history of Canada's First Peoples. Gukshjem, thank you.
Thank you for watching Phyllis Webstad's story. It is estimated that over 150,000 First Nations, Inuit, and Métis children between the ages of 4 and 16 years old attended Indian residential schools in Canada. Many of them never came home. Today, we are looking for the remains of these lost children so that they can return home. For more information, to get involved at BHS, we meet on Wednesdays in C318 during senior lunch. You can also visit the websites in the description below.
Wear an orange shirt on September 30th. If you don't have one, the BHS Truth and Reconciliation Committee invites you to the art gallery during your recess or lunch hour on Wednesday, September 29th. We will be giving away orange ribbons that you can pin on your clothing. You can also participate in a free draw for an orange Every Child Matter t-shirt just like this one. Thank you for all your support.
Thank you for that message. There are two links related to Orange Shirt Day in the description below. There's more information on the VHS website if you wish to read it.
Well, that's it for today. Please note that the Bison News is available on the VHS website, through your homeroom teacher on Google, and right here on YouTube. Well, that's it for this week.
Bye. Ciao, bud.